outcome of the duel here on BBC One now, as we begin our coverage of the final of this year's Masters Snooker Championship. It's introduced by Tony Gubba.
This is snooker's latest pot of gold, the Benson and Hedges Masters Trophy. And for the player who wins this prize today, there's a cheque for £100,000 and his name will be engraved on the list of 16 previous winners. For the last 2 years in succession, that honour has gone to Stephen Hendry, and today he can make it three in a row.
I keep thinking the law of averages, I'm going to lose at some point, and I'm just hoping every match that I play that it's not going to be this match, you know.
Nobody's won the title three times in succession. Cliff Thorburn won it three times, but there was a break in between.
It's certainly a big incentive to do it, to be the first to do that. It'd be tremendous, really. I enjoy the tournament very much.
I bet he does, because he's never yet lost in this tournament. And Stephen Hendry, the world's number one player, has looked so impressive here at Wembley this week that he's quoted at 6-1 on to win the title today. And indeed, the man that he meets in the final, Mike Hallett, has almost been overlooked. But Hallett, too, has played some excellent snooker this week, and never more so than when he came back from being two frames down in his semi-final last night against former Masters champion Terry Griffiths to win 6-3 on a black ball finish in the ninth frame. A win that put him into a really big payday.
I mean, I'm just glad to be there, and, you know, I was there 3 years ago. But I've got a young man called Stephen Hendry. But he's playing some terrific snooker as well, so I look forward to that.
Indeed, he has played great snooker. They both have, and it should be a smashing final. Played over 17 frames here at the Wembley Conference Centre, the first seven of which come in this afternoon's session. Now, what can we tell you that you don't already know about Stephen Hendry? The 22-year-old, pride of Scotland, is world champion. He's the world's number one ranked player. And he's dropped only two frames in his three matches so far against John Virgo, Tony Mio, and then Jimmy White, who was brushed aside with ease in the semi-finals. Hallett, less well known, is nevertheless the world's seventh ranked player. He's 31, he comes from Grimsby, and he was a finalist in the Masters in 1988 when he was whitewashed 9-0 by Steve Davis. This week he's beaten Alan McManus, Neil Foles and Terry Griffiths, and a win in the Benson and Hedges Masters tournament would certainly be the biggest achievement of his career so far. Well, the two players are at the table for the first frame, and our commentators are Ted Lowe and John Spencer.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. The first frame, Stephen Hendry to break. Foul for Mike Hallett.
Well, not a very good way to start a final. Seventeen frames to go.
One.
Well, that's certainly a confident start by Mike there, but I think he'd been a little unfortunate in going into the pike. it would appear then that this first red may go into the corner pocket.
To Wembley 4 years ago for his first appearance in this Masters tournament. He made the final on that occasion, but would prefer to forget it. He lost 9-0 to Steve Davis.
Yes, Ted, and taking that into account, of course.
27.
This start that Mike's made is so important to him.
Spider.
Confidence there, John.
Yes, a tremendous start for him, and plenty of reds available.
35. 36. Forty-9. 50. Fifty-7. 58.
Mike Hallett wastes no time in making up his mind at snooker. Has a different attitude towards matrimony. He's been with his sweetheart 14 years and they're about to get married in June.
65. 66.
66. Looks as though he's got a little straight on this blank. But of course, already got the frame safe.
73. 74. 80.
And still four reds to go. Well, a terrific break there for the start of the final from Mike Hallett. The world champion, of course, has only broken off and running off on that occasion, so we'll want to get just a little used to the table. So it's quite natural that he should continue in this first frame, although, of course, he's fully aware that he has no chance of taking the frame.
8. Nine. 16. 17.
Happy man.
24. Thirty-two.
So, the first of our 17 frames, a terrific frame with just two visits to the table following
34.
The World Championship, World Champions break off.
37. 41. 46. 52.
2 breaks, 80 from Mike Hallett, 59 from Stephen Hendry. The first frame is over, and on the board to Mike Hallett. Oh, what a performance that was, John. I think it's fair to say that most people thought this final was a foregone conclusion for the world champion.
Yes.
How do you feel about it?
Yes, I think that was the opinion of most people, but of course Mike showed there that he's capable of beating anyone in the world if he's on form. And of course that, getting that one frame on the board after his 9-0 defeat, as you say, on his previous final here, is just what he needed. It'll give him all the confidence in the world.
Yes, he's had one or two defeats from the world's number one, hasn't he? And that also must have been in his mind. So, a great start for Mike Hallett.
The second frame, Mike Hallett to break.
1 wonders if we're looking towards another entry into the record books. This young man, if he takes this title, will have won it for three consecutive years, a record that nobody else has done.
Well, that's the best that Stephen could do there. He's left Mike a choice of reds into the centre. But, of course, tight up against a cushion like that, and he knows, should he miss it, you believe in Stephen.
One. Six. Seven.
Well, pink and black tied up, which makes it a little difficult for Mike. And I think here he's hoping to get an angle on this red to try and disturb the black.
18.
Unfortunately, I don't think he's gone high enough up the table. Wanted to be a little higher so he could knock the red away from the black.
19. Bingo. 19, Mike Hallett.
That shot in itself was a sign of confidence. Could have played safe off quite a few reds there, but decided to release the pink. Has Mike put a plant on there into this corner pocket? Apparently not.
Thank you.
two young stars there are from the same stable, headed by Ian Doyle up in Scotland.
Stephen overhit that one. I'm certain we'll see Mike have a go at one of these reds.
White.
Yep.
He's picking them out, John.
Yes, and they're going in as clean as a whistle.
One, Mike Hallett.
That looks to be a very careless shot there from Mike. I think Stephen can get through to these three reds. That shot could cause Stephen some problems unless he can get to the red just above the black. There's no easy path back to the ball, Ken. Looks as if he's trying to get round off the red just above the black.
One. Has to be very careful there.
I think that is one of the things that impresses me most, of course, though, Ted, about Stephen. First frame, his first shot in off. Mike goes on and makes an 80 break. Stephen immediately goes to the table and clears up, and Nothing seems to affect him.
Four.
It's Stephen affected Hendry. Him there, John.
Apart from me. Yes, that was a very bad miss from Stephen. And the way Mike's been playing, this could be very dangerous for Stephen. Certainly six very open reds there.
One. Seven. Eight. Blue ball. Twenty-one.
That pending marriage has created a new Mike Hallett. Seems to be taking much more care and playing far more solid snooker than he used to.
Yes, and Mike 24. Just had a look at the board, which tells him he's 46 in front, 40 in front, 46 with the pink. So another red and pink would leave Stephen needing snookers.
30. 31. The stable is aptly named Q Masters.
Sufficient,
a lead of 54 points and only 43 points left, and Mike Hallett leads 2-0. Well, John, this is a turn-up for the book at the moment, the first two frames, and Mike Hallett playing so brilliantly, and also I noticed in that frame in particular some fabulous safety play.
Yes, I think this is one of the features of Mike's game this week. He's refused some of the shots he used to take on. And his safety has been much better. But, I mean, Stephen's only made two mistakes in two frames. And it's cost him both frames.
Yes, I think it's fair to say that so far, Stephen has not had an opportunity at all in the match. The balls do run that way at times. But, of course, we've got 17 frames to be played all told, so we shall see.
The third frame. Stephen Hendry to break.
Could it be third time lucky? Another red for the same centre pocket.
Yes, and this is one of these frames, Ted, where we could finish with nearly all the reds down the other end of the table. I think Mike's having a double here.
One.
I didn't think he drank.
Well, certainly everything's coming off for Mike at the present time.
One, Mike Hallett.
So often, a missed shot like that changes the whole pattern.
Yes, Ted, and I think that's the first miss we've seen from Mike. In the two previous frames, I don't think he missed a ball he went for.
A long, hard stare at the table. Wonder what the thoughts are. Brilliant.
Well, I'm sure he expected to move the blank a little there, Ted. Certainly doesn't look room for it. From here.
I never dreamt for a moment it would go in there, John, without touching the blank.
Four.
Now that gives them an excellent chance now of potting the black and splitting the pike.
Blow a bit there.
Twelve, Stephen Hendry.
So the world number one is certainly not flowing yet. Mike Hallett here, getting himself all organized. The ice water is now ready, so he can get down to business.
Well, that shot's got Stephen thinking again. Looks as though he's electing to come off the side cushion to play safe. Off the red, just behind the pink.
Inch would have made a big difference there. Pocket.
Oh. Foul. Four. Mike Hallett.
He's certainly suffering a bit at the moment, John.
Yes, things certainly not going Stephen's way. Although he doesn't appear to have done a lot of damage there.
Thank you.
Another good safety from Mike Hallett.
Yes, a little fortunate to finish tight against the cushion like that. Caught the knuckle of the middle pocket, which took the pace out of it.
Well, that will be a... And a miss, Mike Hallett.
And I'm quite sure that Mike won't ask for the ball to be replaced here.
Seven. Eight. Yellow ball. Eleven. 17. 18. Twenty-four.
And Mike taking full advantage of Stephen's mistakes.
37.
Chance here for Mike to clinch this frame at this visit.
38.
Nicely on the black into this right-hand corner pocket. And certainly another red available just in front of the black there.
Yeah.
So 42 points the difference.
Forty-five.
And Stephen there looking a little worried.
46.
So just one red and a colour now.
52. 53.
And Mike won't be too pleased with that. Just needed to get a colour to leave Stephen needing snookers.
53, Mike Hallett.
Well, now you see the difference there. 50 points and 51 points left. So Stephen wants these last three reds, a black with each, and the six colours to be able to win the frame.
And again, quite a nice kiss there for Mike. Stephen can pot this red, but of course needs blacks, really, off all three reds.
He's quite happy. He's left these fairly awkward.
Yes, I don't think Stephen can take this red on.
Well, he had a go at it, John. Yes. And he's going to pay for it.
Yes, I was surprised he took that on at that pace. And this should seal this third frame.
One. Seven. Eight.
Nothing is safe.
27.
The bowl's like pills. The pocket's becoming buckets in the eyes of Mike Hallett.
31.
3 frames to 0. Well, John, this is certainly against all odds, I feel. The first 3 frames going to the young man on the picture, Mike Hallett. I think you have thoughts about Stephen Hendry there.
Yes, of course, the way Mike's playing, no one, you know, it doesn't matter what you do, but the guy's potting the balls like Mike is, there's nothing you can do about it. But the last red Stephen took on there looked like a little bit of desperation setting in. He didn't have the angle to get down for the black. It was a very difficult shot, and I thought he should have pushed the red down the table and waited for an opportunity later on.
Still 14 reds, 14 frames to go in this final.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. The fourth frame. Mike Hallett to break.
Again, the breaker from Mike spread the reds quite a bit, and no easy path for Stephen back to the ball again.
Foul, six. And the miss, Mike Hallett.
Mike Hallett asking for the balls to be replaced.
Yes, and of course John has to put the pink and the red back, as well as the white. But the reason, of course, that a miss was given, he could actually hit a red direct. The one to the left of the black there.
And more side on the cue ball this time.
Well, that's what the rule's for, Ted, and as you can see, having to play it harder, he's now left Mike a red into this left-hand corner pocket.
One.
The benefits, of course, John, of the very good safety by Mike Hallett.
That's right. I think this has been one of the major aspects of Mike's game this week. I mean, today it's just... he just potted Stephen off the table.
Six.
At present.
And he keeps finding little bits on the cue ball.
Seven.
Well, we're into the fourth frame, Ted, and...
12.
In actual potable balls, I don't think Mike's missed three.
13.
No, it was just crossing my mind. I wonder what the odds were prior to the start of this final, as we come up to the mid-session interval, that Mike Hallett might be leading 4-0. Stephen's done nothing really wrong so far in this final. He's just not able to get to the table.
His fourth mistake, and very important here for Stephen to string a sizable break together.
One. Six.
has to get back for the blue.
Seven.
As you can see, the pink and black are denied him at the moment.
Nineteen.
Up to now, Stephen, the world's number one, has not lost a match in 3 years here at Wembley. Uncharacteristic, that. Very rare you see him miss those.
Yes, and that can only give Mike even more confidence, of course.
1.
Now this is going to be a chance for Mike. Pink on its spot. And probably run through for this red near the back cushion.
Seven. Eight.
And that looks to be just about perfect to disturb the reds.
14.
It appears said that red to the right of the black is potable.
Indeed.
14. 15, 22, 23.
31 points ahead.
29. 30.
Just run out of position there. But certainly as good an exhibition of potting as you're likely to see.
And taking no chances.
30, Mark Hallett.
32 points the lead. 43 points left. There's little of this one sticking out. He's going to the left-hand red.
And that was a great shot there from Stephen. Exact pace.
And equally good from Mike, John.
Yes, probably even better from the position he was in.
Just can't get going.
Mike, when we're trying to get the white down behind that green and blue.
They won't go.
Yes, you wonder, 10 is the pressure getting to Stephen. Very unusual for him to miss those type of pots and just redden the colour required by Mike to leave Stephen needing snookers yet again.
One.
So now 39 points in front, 35 on the table.
Seven, Mike Hallett.
And there's the rub of the green, he's left a snooker.
Yes, of course, Ted, Stephen wants one snooker to tie as it is. And with the black tied up on the side cushion there. Well, certainly needs two snookers now.
It never rains but what it pours.
Seven.
A good look at the scoreboard. A difference of 32 points. Only 27 points there, so two snookers required.
Seven, Stephen Hendry.
Well, that's, I don't know what Stephen played there, but completely overhit it.
Two.
An amazing start then to this 17 frame final. The world's number one star. Not being able to show us anything that we know he can do, and being completely outpotted by his stablemate, Mike Hallett.
Nine.
The first one to nine, that 14. Is nine frames on the scoreboard, picks up £100,000 and the Golden Masters Trophy. Terrific performance as Mike Hallett goes to tee, leading four frames to nil.
Thought that Hallett would lead at the interval by four frames to nil. Are you sure? Stephen Hendry's chance of getting his name onto the Benson and Hedges Masters Trophy for a third year in succession seems to have faded in almost the first hour of the final. The first winner of the tournament, back in 1975, of course, was one of our own commentators, John Spencer, and he's seen every one of those finals since. But, John, surely never anything as unexpected as this.
No, I must confess, I don't think anyone expected this, but, of course, Mike has always been capable of this. And I don't think it's Stephen that's, you know, played that bad in the first four frames. It's just Mike has potted him off the table.
And what's this going to do to Stephen Hendry's confidence? He's gone away, he's got a few minutes to think about it now, but he's 4-0 down.
That's right, and he showed a bit of pressure, I think, in the second last game when he wanted three blacks with the last three reds, and he took a red on that he'd virtually no chance of getting a black off. You know, and that's the first time I've really seen Stephen look so frustrated.
Because it was a disastrous start for him, wasn't he? He went in off with his very first strike at the start of frame one, and then there was a massive break against him. He'd lost the first frame before he'd...
That's right. Mike went in and knocked 80 in. And then Stephen cleared up with, I think it was a 56. But again, Mike had got his confidence, and I think the last time Mike played in the final, of course, he lost 9-0.
Against Steve Davis.
Against Steve Davis. Yeah. And I think once he got that first frame on the board, I think it would ease a lot of pressure. You know, the fact that he'd avoided the whitewash, and then he just went from strength to strength. And I don't care who it was he'd have played. There's no way. This is the funny thing with snooker, of course. There's nothing you can do when you're sat in the chair.
Of course, the thing also that we should underline is that the last time Hallett lost to Hendry, I think, was last year, and he lost so badly to him that he snapped his cue into six pieces. He was so disgusted, Hallett.
That's right. It's amazed me how he stuck it back together again.
No, I think it's a new one, actually.
This is what the game's about, you know. And of course, going in 4-3 in front gives him that psychological advantage. There's only seven frames this afternoon, so he knows that he's in front tonight before they start. You know, with three frames to go, so he's got to be oozing with confidence.
Yeah. What are we seeing here? Are we seeing an eclipse of Steve Hendry, the world champion, or are we seeing perhaps a great final gathering momentum, and which is going to develop this afternoon and tonight?
As a snooker player, I wish we were seeing a demise of Stephen Hendry, but I'm certain we're not. No, Stephen will be back. I mean, he's not lost this match yet. You know, he proved the first frame. He went in and cleared up with a 50-odd. But then he seemed a little bit out of sorts in certainly the last two frames. He played one or two uncharacteristic shots for Stephen.
Sure. They are doubles partners, aren't they? So they know each other very well. What do you think Hallett's... What do you think he's gone out there with a policy of doing? How has he set about this final?
Well, I don't think, you know, getting to know one another's play doesn't mean anything at this game. The balls break differently every time you go, and you just play, you know, you play the balls. And as I say, the way Mike has knocked them in, he just potted Stephen off the table. Probably the best potting I've seen in four frames of snooker.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I think I was talking to you a little earlier before we came to the interview, and you were saying always that Hallett was a confident player, Was that what you were saying?
That's right. And of course, when he got the 80 break in the first frame, that gave him the confidence, and then Steve missed a couple of easy shots, which again, you know, once you've made a mistake and your opponent lets you in again, it builds your confidence up again. And of course, Mike just oozes, he'll be oozing confidence at the present time.
OK, John, thanks for joining us. Well, the defending champion, the world number one, the world champion, Stephen Hendry, has had a 20-minute break now to collect his thoughts and rethink. There are three more frames to play in this afternoon's session, and we'll join them for the start of frame five with Clive Everton and Ray Edmonds.
Well, this is a very interesting juncture. Mike Hallett had had 20 minutes in his dressing room to think about being 4-0 up. And that 20 minutes could have just taken the edge off his concentration, and thoughts of winning have intruded. Same token, Hens had that 20 minutes to get himself psyched up for a major effort.
Six. Six, Stephen Hendry.
Well, by the look of that shot, Stephen has come out with the intention of hitting himself out of trouble, but he may well hit himself into deeper trouble. Very ambitious attempt, that one. But it's worked out well for him.
Thank you. Gentlemen, before we start, please, no shouting.
Yes, this venue is used for boxing sometimes. A few of the spectators getting a bit confused, possibly.
One. Four. Eleven. Twelve. Nineteen.
Just being ultra careful, didn't get a kick there, but these kind of delicate shots are the ones where you're particularly liable to do so. But I think it would be fair to say, Clive, that Stephen didn't play badly in the first half of this match.
27.
Mike Hallett just knocked him off the table somewhat.
28.
Yes, Hendry did miss a couple, but Hallett played exceptionally well.
35.
Hendry hasn't been lucky there. Went into the bunch at fair pace, but has left nothing.
35, Stephen Hendry.
Quite a clever shot from Mike Hallett there. Making Stephen come up the table for the Reds. But equally clever return from Stephen Hendry.
Yes, he made sure that Hallett couldn't see the red nearest the yellow. Hendry's looked at the possible plant on the two reds to the middle pocket, but that looks to be set well off. Good safety. Too thin, so instead of leaving the cue ball tight under the top cushion, he leaves Hallett an easy pot to the middle.
Seven.
Eight.
12. Nineteen. Twenty-seven. Twenty-eight.
Open reds have disappeared now, but Mike trying to bring one into play on the right-hand side of the table. Didn't get it right, but has run very nicely onto this one. But it's getting a little more difficult now. And this a big shot. An angle on the pink here to disturb the two reds on the right of the pitcher.
Forty-one.
To level the scores.
45.
Hasn't got the ideal angle on the black to hold the cue ball for the red. Very delicate shot. But he's playing everything with such confidence this afternoon.
52. 53.
Great chance now.
60.
Only the yellow and green needed.
62 65 69.
This has been a superb break. There were some easy reds at the start, then some difficult ones.
74.
But they've all come alike to Hallett.
80.
80. And with that superb 87 clearance, Mike Hallett leads by 5-0. And I just wonder, Ray, whether we're seeing that moment in a player's career when someone goes forward from being a world-class player among the group of leading players to becoming a genuine household name by winning something major on television.
Yes, well, it does on those of us who know Mike for quite some time have known that he's always had the break building ability, always had the flair, but he has sometimes lacked that little bit of coolness in a crisis and perhaps not played the right safety shot at the right time, but he's putting it all together today. And quite honestly, Stephen Hendry, his opponent, is not being allowed to play at his best. One half error in the last frame, and that cost him it.
Mike Hallett to break.
Hendry's got to just keep cool, concentrate on winning the remaining two frames of the afternoon. 5-2 behind going into the evening session would not be irrecoverable. Good length on the safety, but unforeseeably a red drifted out of the pack and over the pocket.
This is the time when Mike Hallett's adrenaline used to run a bit fast and he'd have taken the black on by now. A little more circumspect and quite rightly, I think, taking the yellow and keeping the pressure on the world champion.
Terrific pot. I'm not sure whether the pink is potable to the middle. Oh yes, comfortably.
Seven. Fourteen, Mike Hallett. Six, Stephen Hendry.
Very good pot. Very unlucky to go in off, although counting into the black, he couldn't have much idea where the cue ball was going to finish.
Stephen Hendry.
Lost his concentration on the simple blue. Pity after such a good opening red.
One. Seven. Eight.
Needed to be straight on the black. For the middle. A little bit tricky at this angle. But if Mike Hallett can really
15
take advantage of this chance and make Stephen Hendry pay for that missed blue, it'll be a double wound in the side of the young Scot. He'll remember that.
Done with the cue ball running on a little, so that he could have just taken it gently through the black from this red.
24.
A nicely played cannon on the blue, though, holds him in position for the pink. 30, 31, 38, 39. 46. 47. 53. 54. Hallett's taken full advantage of Hendry's blunder on the blue. A large number of snookers required now. Even if Hallett should miss this.
60. 61. 67.
So Hendry knows he's going to be 6-0 down.
68.
Continues to play beautifully. 6-0 up, and thirds of the way towards the total of 9 that he needs to win the £100,000 first prize, and by far the most important title of his career. He did win the Hong Kong Open, of course, 18 months ago. That was a world ranking tournament, but this unquestionably would carry more prestige and have more impact. And I can't help looking back a lot of years to when I first knew Mike. I saw him win the British Under-16 Championship, and you, of course, Ray, have known him even longer as a fellow Grimbarian.
Yes, I'm rather pleased he wasn't around when I was at my best in Grimsby, Clive, because I may well not have been the best, but he really has been a revelation today, because there was no sign this week in his matches against the other opponents, although he'd played fairly well. There was no sign that he was in this kind of form, and it's a tremendous performance against the young man coming to the table.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. The final frame of this session, Stephen Hendry to break.
So, for the second time within a month, there is the possibility of Stephen Hendry, the world champion, suffering a session whitewash. Jimmy White won the opening session of their Mercantile Classic final, 9-0. Went on to win 10-4. Hendry could be 7-0 down at the interval this afternoon. Was a good safety from Hendry. Trapped Hallett into a mistake, but he's got away with it. Yes, Hendry's escape needed to be full ball onto the red. Just caught it half ball, and that left the chance.
Eight. Nine. Twenty-four. 25.
Tremendous cue power.
33.
The bookmakers made Stephen Hendry something like 7-1 on to win this match, which were quite ridiculous odds. There was no way that Stephen was that warm a favourite, but I really couldn't begin to guess what 40. Odds it would be that this young man was 6-0 down at this stage. Probably 1,000-1.
Yeah.
You must know different bookmakers to the ones I know, Ray. But it's been a terrific performance from Hallett. Five reds, five blacks in this break. It's 8/30 in 7 frames. Well, a kiss on the pink would have been sweet. But there may not be a potable red now.
48, white colour.
6 reds, 6 blacks, though. 6-0 and 48-0 in this. Well, those shots look a lot more difficult when you're 6-0 down than when you're 6-0 up. And Hallett now has got an opening from which he could make it 7-0.
Seven. Eight. Eleven. 15.
So just good position off this one required. On to the next red.
21.
We've seen odd results like this from time to time at snooker throughout the years. 22. But this is about as devastating a session for the underdog that I've seen.
28.
That I can remember.
29.
29, friends. An absolutely devastating session from Mike Hallett. He whitewashes Stephen Hendry 7-0 and needs only two frames this evening to become Masters champion.
Well, surely an understatement to say that that's not the scoreline we expected after the afternoon session. Hallett ahead by 7-0. And the question for John Spencer has got to be, how demoralised is Stephen Hendry?
Well, he must wonder what's hit him. I mean, Mike has just potted him off the table. But he started to crack after the interval, Stephen. You know, he showed signs of wear. But he'll be thinking about tonight. It's a different session. I think he certainly needs to get the first two frames tonight.
Yeah, can he come back?
Well, if he wins the first two, then I would say yes. If he doesn't win the first two, if Mike gets one of the first two frames, I would think it would be all over.
See, that's the key, isn't it? We've seen players come back from this sort of deficit before between afternoon and evening sessions, but that's been in longer matches. There could only be two more frames left.
That's right. But last month in the match play, of course, he won the first four against Jimmy after being 9-0 down. But big uphill struggle, I'm afraid.
Final thought, come on, predict what's going to happen for us.
I think I'd have to tip Mike.
Obviously a gambling man. Thanks very much indeed, John. So there it is. He's ahead by 7-0, Mike Hallett. It was just not what we expected at all. His best break in that afternoon session was, what, an 80 in frame one. So Mike Hallett isn't currently on the list of century breaks in the tournament. There it is. There is a £10,000 prize for the biggest of the tournament, and that currently belongs to Dennis Taylor, with this break of 135, which he did in his only match against Terry Griffiths.
Yeah.
Well, Dennis weighing up the possibility of an open red there, but he's got to be very accurate with the cue ball, bearing in mind that he cannot afford any mistakes.
Twelve. 30.
Well, that was certainly a cracker. That degree of safety with it, but nevertheless.
Well, that wasn't so well played by Dennis. The red at the back of the pack is on for the corner. I would like to have been a little straighter.
29.
Well, the way he's hesitating, I don't think he can get through to the black, so it's got to be a deep screw here. Oh, and that's come out quite well. So a good blue and reds all over the place.
42. Yes, a little bit annoyed with himself there. The only place virtually at that end of the table that he could be awkward, and Dennis has found it. I think at the finish he'll still come round and take the shot on, and just that he's not going to be able to do a lot with the cue ball. But he doesn't have to as long as the red goes in.
Fifty-six. Sixty-four.
Well, Dennis just needs the black to be virtually sure of winning this frame, and it's been a pretty good effort because he's certainly thrown one frame away this afternoon, and one, as I said, possibly two of them. So
71.
Important now he clear up, and this will restore his confidence.
Yes, Ryan, he's got a chance 72. To. Put himself on the scoreboard for the highest break. It's 107 to beat. 79. It was Doug Mountjoy that made the break, so every chance here.
80.
There's a wry smile on Dennis's face there. He needed to be pretty well straight on the pink, and then it was so easy to drop on the last red. Still should get there, but having to take the white across the table.
Well, a lovely, tidy frame. Colours on their spots now, so
108. Thank you, gentlemen. 113. 117. 122.
Well, the prize for the highest break is £10,000, so this is worth really
128.
Knocking the black in.
135.
So 135 clear, and it's a beautiful break by Dennis Taylor.
And just one session left to dislodge Dennis Taylor's 135 from taking the 10,000 prize. Hallett, of course, still with time to improve on his 125, and Hendry to improve on his 131. You know, it's an indication of how much the money has increased in snooker over the years that £10,000 was the prize on offer 7 years ago for anyone who did the 147 maximum. It was won that year, as the musical memories of 1984 will remind us.
Looking at you. First on BBC One, we join Tony Gubba for continuing coverage of the 1991 Masters Final. Good evening. When Stephen Hendry went in off at the start of the Benson and Hedges Masters final this afternoon, there were smiles of amusement in the audience here at the Wembley Conference Centre. It was such an uncharacteristic slip by the world champion. When Mike Hallett's first visit to the table produced a frame-winning break of 80, there were raised eyebrows. And less than an hour later, there was a buzz of disbelief as the players left for the first interval with Mike Hallett leading the defending champion by 4-0. Well, there were still 3 frames left to play in the afternoon session, and surely Stephen Hendry would soon begin to justify being the 6-1 on favourite. Well, the final is, of course, the best of 17 frames. There are still 10 more to play this evening, but Mike Hallett needs just 2 more for what will be a really sensational victory. The evening session is about to begin. We're going to go live to join the audience here at Wembley as the players are introduced by the MC, Norman de Mesquita.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, first, we welcome a young man making his 3rd appearance at Wembley. He's yet to be beaten here, as he was the winner last year and the year before. And to reach this evening's final, he's beaten John Virgo, Tony Meo, and Jimmy White. He's ranked number 1 in the world. Welcome, please, Stephen Hendry. His opponent is making his 4th appearance here at Wembley, and it's the 2nd time he's reached the final because he was the runner-up here in 1988. He's beaten Alan McManus, Neil Folds, and Terry Griffiths to reach here this evening. He's ranked number 7 in the world. Welcome, please, Mike Hallett. Mr. John Street.
Well, the question is, how much has Stephen Hendry got himself together during a break of about 3 hours? Who would have dreamt that Hallett would have a chance of winning 9-0? Commentators are Jack Carnham and Ray Edmonds.
Mike Hallett and Ray.
So the opening shot's played, and as previously said, sensation indeed. I wonder now if this young man can increase on that sensation and do something about it.
Thank you.
And all these shots that Stephen has in these opening stages, such as this, are real pressure shots, believe me. He cannot afford any mistakes.
Foul seven. And a miss. Mike Hallett.
And Mike Hallett says, play again.
Yes, Stephen was very close to the red, but as you'll see when John Street replaces the cue ball there, he can hit lots of reds clearly. And if he comes off a cushion, he's got to make contact with a red when he can hit another one full ball. But he got the range the first time, and he's played that one to perfection.
Well, an excellent putt. And I would suggest, Ray, that this opening frame is extremely important, particularly to Stephen, but more, just as much almost to Mike. If there's going to be a comeback, Stephen must win the first one, that's for sure.
Six. Seven.
Yes, I think I would agree with you, Jack, but again, Stephen really hasn't made any unforced error this first frame. And brilliant first pot from Mike Hallett. And
14.
The balls are situated very nicely here.
15.
Well, he certainly he can't 30. Put a foot wrong. It's quite incredible how well he's played.
31.
Well, played for the blue, I think, but nice angle on one of the lower colours.
35. Bad shot Mike has played. Didn't really get through the ball and get the backspin on it. Still a shot to nothing there.
35. Mike Hallett.
crowd suddenly enthusiastic
Thank
applause
you,
there, trying their best to urge young Stephen. Believe me, this young man, he's got plenty of bottle. He won't lay down. Bit of good fortune there, and he's had it, and he hasn't had much so far.
Don't think he can get through past the pink. If he plays that one, he's going to have to play it with a touch of left-hand side, and it's always a bit tricky. And there you see him cueing deep at the left-hand side of that cue ball. And the side...
23.
Working for him. And it's most important for Stephen that he really does make full use of this opportunity. He looks cool, calm and collected. So he goes ahead. Needs both these reds.
60.
With a colour in between to virtually assure himself of this frame. I think the red will go to the far corner, but Stephen taking this one on because he may not have another better chance of getting on it.
Tremendous relief 16. For Stephen there White when Hallett. He saw the
Sorry,
red wriggle down the table a bit. It's right behind the black. And that's the sort of run that he needs.
Mike may attempt to drop the red dead weight into the centre pocket, but really a very difficult shot. Well, what can one say? Tremendous shot.
Well, I couldn't agree with you more, Ray. I must comment with you there. That really was quite a shot. And to take that chance, it's really it's opened the frame up for him, and this is such a big frame.
Six.
So now the colours... Seven. On their spots.
Seven. Mike Hallett.
Well, that is amazing. Well, that's the run of the balls. The cue ball in the pocket, my goodness me.
The only request they make is that you act like gentlemen as well. Keep quiet.
Well, there's a comment by John Street there asking for a little silence. And Stephen must be extremely disappointed there.
Two. Five.
Well, Mike, he's feeling rather hurt there. That was virtually the frame there. He's dropped about 15 inches short of that brown.
Nine.
And Mike totally unhurried. He's had some hidings in recent times, and he's no doubt relishing the fact that he's getting a little bit of home back as well here.
14.
So just the pink. Well, if Stephen pops the pink here, it's going to go automatically behind the black. It's all about the pink. Fate took a hand there. Yeah. So well done, Stephen. A very vital frame indeed. 7-1, Mike Hallett leads. Well now, what an opening frame and what a relief for Stephen Hendry. Well, Ray. We said at the start that it would all be about the first frame, and I still have a sneaky feeling that if Stephen can win 2 or 3 frames, this match will still be alive.
Yes, I'm sure you're right, Jack. The point is, when Mike Hallett hit the ball at the start of this frame today, he was very much the underdog. I have to say, very few people really expected him to win. They thought he might put up a very good show, but... having taken 7 frames this afternoon, the role is completely the reverse. The pressure, in a way, is off Stephen now. He can't get any worse than 7-0, so he will relax a little. And Mike Hallett, of course, has only got one way to do. He's got to play 2 good frames, but everyone is expecting him to do it fairly easily. So I think there could still be a fair amount of play left in this match.
Well, at least he's smiling, and... Well, there's the trophy that Stephen knows all about. He's had that twice in his possession. And perhaps not finding it quite so easy for a third. But whilst we're talking a lot about Stephen, we must say that Mike Hallett has really played out of his skin so far.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, the 9th frame. Stephen Hendry to break.
So frame 9, and Stephen breaks off. Well, he's got a brown there if he wanted to go up amongst the reds, but he's deciding to force the errors rather than risk, and I think he's pretty wise.
Yeah.
might have a go at this one. Gentle screw shot.
One. Six, Stephen Hendry.
Well, at least he got away from the Reds. And... Well, everything's very tight. Oh, and what a cracking shot.
One.
And who's next?
Ramble. One.
Well, a little smile from Mike there. I'll bet he's never battled so hard for a frame in his life.
A situation as ever that the Reds aren't difficult to hit, but trusting to luck as to whether he gets a thin contact and gets the cue ball away. And well deserving that round of applause.
Certainly an easy red, but it's not easy to control the cue ball from that distance.
One.
I'm rather surprised that he went for that, Ray.
What? Mike Hallett.
Yes, me as well, Jack, but he went for a big shot there to open the Reds up. And somehow he's found a path through the middle of those. So a little bit lucky there, Mike.
That looks very close.
Foul. Four. Mike Hallett.
Well, not a great deal of damage.
One. And now we join Tony Gubba at the Wembley Conference Centre for the concluding frames of the final of the 1991 Masters.
Thank you.
Good evening to you. When Stephen Hendry began the evening session in this year's Benson and Hedges Masters snooker final, he trailed Mike Hallett by 7-0. The defending champion hadn't won a single frame in the afternoon. And here at Wembley tonight, he faced perhaps the most difficult snooker session of his life, trying to prevent Hallett from winning the 2 frames that he needed for victory. Well, in our programme earlier this evening, we saw Hendry win the first frame of the evening, and he won the next frame too. But Hallett took frame 10 to lead 8-2, and he needs just one more. Hallett's back at the table in frame 11, but he's just watched Hendry score a break of 30.
But he mustn't start taking unnecessary risks.
One. Six. Seven.
Well, and that could be
13.
A frame winner. Immediately there, Stephen asked for the cue ball to be cleaned, not because he had a bad contact, but because he came down very heavily on the cue ball. No doubt marked it with chalk. Mike trying very hard to keep relaxed and concentrated.
26.
And of course that's very important when you're a player's opponent's playing, is to keep watching.
31.
So he's lost his way there a little with 60 points ahead and still 67 on the table.
31, Stephen Hendry.
One. That was a great shot from Mike. Certainly, the balls are there, available for Mike if he can just hold his nerve. It'd be a great clearance, especially to win the match.
15. Yes, I was thinking the array that
15.
There was a shot that probably, under different circumstances, he might not have taken on, but
16.
It was a question of possibly lose the frame or go for broke.
22.
And anxious moments now for Stephen.
23.
And this, the, sorry, Jack, this the all-important red.
30.
Stephen can't do a thing about it.
31. I suggest that that is the match winner. Ball's very nicely situated here.
34.
Slowing down, just getting himself together. 100,000 pounds on the line, yeah? So 21 points behind and 22 remaining.
43.
Rather tentative, maybe a little bit of elbow in that. 48. Big shot. Now, just look at this. Now, 48. Has it got away?
Mike Hallett.
The cheer goes up, and Stephen Hendry pulls another one back. It is now 8 frames to 3.
And Hallett had a break of 41 at the start of frame 12, but Hendry came from behind to win it. Hallett's had another break of 41 at the start of frame 13. Hendry's at the table with 11 points on the board.
One, 5, 6.
Unlucky. He suffered very badly today. His face shows it. 21 points the difference now.
Yes, that was unbelievable how he got between those reds. And he just flicked the first red.
11.
And was four up nicely.
Perfect strength there.
Hendry.
Still has to get over that winning line.
One.
A bit short.
Yes, and electing to take the yellow to come down for position.
Three.
Got the right angle on the blue to drop onto one of these reds. May have to try and just screw the ball gently to kiss into one of the reds.
Nine.
And still he struggles. 8 points in it.
He's just about got the angle to force this blue in and come across the table for the red into the right-hand corner.
One point behind. 16.
The green is now a problem.
21.
Yes, but he looks to have the perfect angle to just drop behind the green here.
23.
So just brown and blue required.
30.
Just trickle this pink into that center. A very acute angle.
35, Stephen Hendry.
So Hallett needed a snooker and he didn't get it. Hendry had won 3 frames in a row. No points have yet been scored in frame 14. Stephen Hendry at the table.
Apologises for the fluke, but the tension on the table is spreading throughout the Wembley Conference Centre. £150,000 at stake, £100,000 to the winner, £50,000 to the second.
Five. 6. White. Nineteen. 19.
And this time you'll be splitting the rest of the reds when potting this red.
20. Thirty-six. 39.
Didn't quite get into the green enough there. And now just a safety shot.
39, Stephen Hendry.
Stephen made his first entry into this Masters here at Wembley in January 1989. Since then, he's not lost a match here.
One.
Well, a tremendous pot there from Mike. Again, forced into it. Well, very, very fortunate to finish on the pink like that. Too happy with that shot. Wanted to be much further down the table.
14.
15. And now this could be the big shot. You're trying to split the reds off this.
15. Mike Hallett.
And Mike Hallett annoyed with himself over that.
One. Six. Seven.
Yes, and I feel we might go into pay dearly here. Because when Steve moves this 13. Bottom red, of course, it opens the other red into the opposite corner pocket.
40.
It just requires the pink and one more red to leave might need in snookers.
And John Stevens just had a good look at the scoreboard while the referee John Street was cleaning things up there. The world champion lost the first seven frames of this 17-frame final.
Twenty-one. 37.
Fantastic performance then by the world's number one star here. Tried to shift that last red but didn't quite catch it.
33.
Already done enough to win this frame and be within two frames of his stablemate.
Stephen Hendry. And the frame.
And Mike Hallett concedes. So Hendry once again saves this final. Two frames separate them.
Not for long, they didn't, because Hendry rattled in a break of 41 on his way to winning frame 15 and now needs one more to take us into a sensational final frame. Hallett's at the table, but he's trailing 8 points to 14.
So now, can he keep his cool and really make his mark here? Excellent chance.
8. Nine. Sixteen. Seventeen. 24. Twenty-five. 31. Thirty-nine. 40.
The winning post is starting to come in sight again.
Yes, and this isn't the kind of shot that is particularly appealing when you're just a couple of reds and a colour away from virtually certain victory. And again, he hit it at quite a rate of knots.
47.
Certainly he knew that was the possible winning one.
One. Nine.
Well, Stephen Hendry knows that this could possibly be his last chance and taking every precaution. The red on the side cushion seems to be the only particularly awkward ball.
17.
He can drop right behind it on this one.
24.
So,
25, Stephen Hendry.
In the end, Stephen Hendry's nerve went a little.
Certainly did, Clive, and I think he probably got down a bit too quickly there. He could, on reflection, he may well have thought that the blue would have been a better choice of shot, but now can Mike Hallett take his chance this time?
2.
He needs green and brown.
Got a rope.
Well, he might feel like hanging himself if he loses. And will, as they say in the snooker world, do his head in if he loses after being 7-0 up at the interval.
2, Mike Hallett.
Took on a desperately difficult green the way he played it to hold position.
Woo! 3.
Black, still needed.
18.
Yes! So from 7-0 down,
from 8-2 down. Stephen Hendry comes all the way back to 8-all, and it's all on the last.
Now we've got it out of our system, let's have respect for both players. This is the final frame, no shouting at all, please. Stephen Hendry to break.
Well, it sometimes happens that when you've gone past the point of no return, you relax, you can't go any further back than you have been. And that opening red from Mike was a great shot, but it wasn't so good.
Not just Hallett feeling the pressure.
Surprised at Stephen taking that one on. Wanted to find contact to knock the black in, and sure to lead Mike half a chance to the middle.
An awkward stretch without fouling the black. But he made it. Too far for ideal position on the blue. Can't easily get the cue ball towards his next red.
Well,
20. Six.
Disappointing, though. He hit the red sharply, but no potable red has come out. The gods are making it hard for him, as well as his opponent.
26. Mike Hallett.
Good safety, though.
12. Well, Stephen knew that unless he got the cue ball behind the green, he was going to leave Mike a chance of the cut. Well, that is cruel.
4. Stephen Hendry.
And one has to feel very sorry for Mike Hallett. Still, he's 30 points in front. He's just got to forget it and hope he gets another chance.
Come on, Mike!
Shot. The red was very close to the cushion and he had to make a thin contact to avoid the double kiss.
One.
And that was a great shot.
Not be taking the pot on.
One, Stephen Hendry.
Had no way of getting the cue ball down towards the red. Sure to contact the yellow, so putting Mike Hallett in a spot of bother. And queuing's very awkward with the yellow there, so Mike has to be very careful this time.
Shot, and I just wonder whether Mike Hallett possibly has passed through the worst from his point of view.
Yes, I think two or three safety shots has helped Mike to calm down a little. He was getting lots of chances, and now that little one piece of luck that's been lacking in the last two or three frames. I think Mike will have to take this one on.
One.
A good pot it was from tight on the rail, and he can count himself unfortunate that he hasn't enjoyed a friendlier run of the ball. He hasn't got a colour that he can pot.
One, Mike Hallett.
He leaves Hendry very awkward queuing, though.
Well, if this was the first frame of the match, Clive, I'd fancy Mike to knock this red in the middle, but he's got a choice of two, but both very awkward. Possibly even one to the left middle as well, but he knows that missing any one of those three could cost him.
Thank you.
8. Stephen Hendry.
So Hallett still leads by 17 in the deciding frame.
Position this time. But not on this red.
4.
So this frame looks destined to go all the way.
Things considered, it could have been a lot worse from Hallett's point of view. Colours in safe-ish positions now, so that's got to be in Hallett's favour too, with a 21-point lead.
Mike hung his head there, but if the red hadn't dropped in the pocket, he would have been comprehensively snookered, but this is a little awkward behind the pink. Where's the yellow going to finish?
Foul. Stephen Hendry. Back.
Yes, the referee, John Street, has awarded a miss there because Hallett actually struck the brown before he struck the cushion. I think the decision is slightly debatable, but nevertheless, there it is.
Well, yeah, I suppose really that with the brown, yellow being extremely safe, the one should get a little nearer than that.
Foul. 4. Stephen Hendry.
Has he left the free ball?
Free ball.
But it's still pinks over the centre pocket, but still wanting a very good shot from Stephen to get anywhere near the yellow. Mm-hmm.
two.
Yes, Hallett played the escape on the yellow carelessly. He should never have left a free ball. There's a huge margin. Well, again, it's somewhat debatable whether Hendry's better off fluking the yellow. Hallett would have been snookered if it hadn't gone in.
Four. Stephen Hendry.
And now he's fluked a snooker.
Was a good shot on the green, but wanting a better one on the brown. But I must admit, the last 10 minutes or so looks as if Mike Hallett is fated to lose this final.
If Hendry had potted that,
Stephen Hendry,
he would have needed only blue and pink in addition. Not at all how Hallett played it, but at least the brown has finished near the cushion.
Yes, yeah, one of those shots that if you take on and get it, it's the right shot, but if you miss it, it could well cost you the match. And that was the shot of a world champion.
Just the pink. For a hat-trick of Masters titles. And 8-2. He was within two pots of winning 9-2. But Stephen Hendry, world champion that he is, hung on and hung on and hung on and has won by 9 frames to 8.
Tremendous final, and it takes two players to make a tremendous final. So your applause, please, as he comes forward to collect his check for Mike Hallett. And to receive the trophy for the third successive year, the 1991 Benson and Hedges Masters.
Benson and Hedges, Mr. John Taylor. Fantastic final, but that must be no consolation to you, Mike.
Absolutely shattered, Tony. I just can't believe it's happened, you know, but all credit due to Steve, he stuck in there and, like a true champion is, you know.
But, what went wrong?
Well, I played terrific snooker all afternoon and it was nice and relaxed and something. Came out tonight and got a good clearance to go 8-2. And then I was clearing up again, and I've dropped short on the blue, and only wanted the pink and black to win 9-2.
How did that affect you? Because as you said, you had a shot on the pink that surely you would make 99 times out of 100. Yeah, would have put you on the black. You'd have won by one point.
I've dropped short, you know, from the blue. I only needed one good shot, and really should have been all over. But I mean, I know Stephen stuck in there, and suddenly it sort of turned around a little bit, 8-5, 8-6. But after that, I've still had chances. Even in the last frame there, I had the chance, yellow to brown, and. Just didn't, you know, you tighten up. It's just one of those things. But I mean, yeah, I'm absolutely shattered for what's happened. But the atmosphere is terrific. But all credit due to Stephen, he stuck in there at the end.
Indeed, all credit due to Stephen Hendry. I mean, just let's go back to seven frames to nil down before you began tonight. What did you think as you came into the evening session?
You've got to think realistically that you're going to get beat 7-0 down in first and 9. You can't, you know. I thought if I could possibly win the first two frames, then I'm in with a slight chance. But even though, you know, 7-0 down, you've got to think, you know, I'm just trying to make the score a bit more respectable.
That really was your objective, was it, to make it?
Well, mate, it was absolutely flying. You know, I didn't do too much wrong this afternoon. You know, I played some good safeties, and then I ended up back where I started, back on tight in the ball cushion, and then scored heavily as well.
When did you start to think tonight that suddenly you might actually turn a 7-0 deficit into a victory?
Well, I know from experience that the hardest frame to win is the last one. So Mike did... unfortunately for him, miss the pink, and I know that from a player, these shots do stick in your mind. You try to block them out, but it's hard, so it's just a matter of me taking one frame at a time.
I'm sure I'm not alone tonight in feeling a great deal of sympathy for Mike Hallett, but sport is about winners and losers, and you can really only admire the brilliance of Stephen Hendry in winning the Masters Trophy for a third year in succession. A tremendous final. Good night.